VR is good for you. You're about to find out exactly how. Hello and welcome to the VR Cauldron. I'm Al, and today we're taking a break from the games and the Facebook drama to take the time to celebrate virtual reality. More specifically, why it's actually good for you. And I'm not even talking about what you can do in VR, like training in medicine or other industrial applications. This video is all about the benefits of simply gaming in VR, just like you game on your PC or your console. Remember, if you love VR discussion, reviews, big news and gameplay, don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell. Right, in we go. So let's start with the obvious, physical health. I'm splitting this into two parts, active and passive benefits. Remember that image of the gamers from that South Park episode where they play World of Warcraft? Sadly, it's a bit of a stereotype applied to all gamers, wasting away in front of their screens, munching on snacks and drinking Jolt Cola. It's part of the reason parents are forever telling their kids that they play too many games just before they themselves settle down for yet another Grey's Anatomy marathon. Out of TV, movies, reading and gaming has always been the one that's been frowned upon. The poor cousin. Never mind the fact that it's been training our reflexes, problem solving and teamwork skills. Oh no, it's been melting our brains and making us bad, bad people. Well, no more. On top of that list of gaming benefits, virtual reality improves our physical health. And I'm not even talking about the obvious workout games like FitXR or Thrill of the Fight. Yes, these are amazing and you can actively burn more calories playing them than you do with most other forms of exercise. But the benefits of VR for exercise is multifaceted and not simply that there's some games that give you a workout. Firstly, simply playing most VR games means you'll be standing up and moving your arms around and possibly walking around. You're now burning more calories and no longer what doctors call sedentary. One of the biggest threats to your heart health is having a sedentary lifestyle. You can have a great diet or even exercise a few times a week, but if you sit down a lot, you'll eventually feel the effects. Weight gain is one which leads to a whole host of health issues such as heart disease, diabetes, and high blood pressure. Your muscles will gradually become weaker due to lack of use, but also reduced blood flow which causes a loss of flexibility. Dementia, depression, and anxiety is also a consequence of lack of body movement. The body and mind are closely linked, more on that later. So by simply having the player on their feet, reaching for objects and turning around, virtual reality is passively helping prevent a sedentary lifestyle and all the negatives that come with it. And the best thing is, you're just playing computer games. That's pretty big if you ask me. But we're not done with exercise. I've told a few people that I use Thrill of the Fight to exercise, and although most are intrigued, some say things like, isn't it just shadow boxing? Well, yes, I am swinging at nothing and I'm not getting hit. I could just shadow box instead. That way I don't have to spend hundreds of pounds on a headset. But seriously, I think I could shadow box for about 1 minute before becoming extremely bored. And that's another reason why exercise in VR is so compelling. It's competitive. It motivates you. It's the fact that I don't want to lose a fight that keeps me going in VR boxing. I put the extra effort in to try to score a knockdown, and I put the extra effort in to avoid getting knocked down myself. You don't have that in shadow boxing. But it's not limited to sport or boxing titles. Some of the biggest games in VR give you a fantastic workout, and sometimes you don't even realise because it's just so darn fun. Beat Saber, Pistol Whip, Blade and Sorcery, Gorn, Skyrim VR, to name a few, have all got you ducking and diving and swinging away. And anyone who's tried using a bow and arrow in VR will tell you just how much of an arm workout it is. Now the third part is diet control. If you go to the cinema, watch TV or play pancake games, what else are you probably doing? That's right, you're probably eating. Well, I know I'd be. Well, in VR, it's pretty hard to eat. You can eat, but it's not as mindlessly easy as you can when you're not inside a headset. I don't need to explain why this is a good thing, so play more VR and eat less. Number four, passive mental health. I've already touched on how your physical health can influence your mental health, but mental health can receive so many other benefits in virtual reality. It's no secret that a lot of people have struggled during lockdown through lack of interaction with friends or peers. Some single parents have been stuck in their houses with the kids they've had to teach all day with no one to talk to in the evening. It's not surprising that gin sales have been through the roof. Zoom has gone a long way to help with this, but virtual reality allows actual face-to-face interactions. Okay, it's not necessarily their real faces, but talking to someone in a virtual world can feel very real, and how a person feels is extremely important. There's a reason why 2020 has been a great year for VR. Part 5, I'm going to call active mental health. Just like with exercise, VR allows us to improve our mental health both passively and actively. The increased immersion that VR gives us means that meditation and relaxation is something VR is extremely good at. With programs such as guided Tai Chi, Nature Treks VR among others, many people are using VR to relax and relieve stress. But you don't even need to buy programs that are specifically tailored for meditation to do these things. You can actually relieve stress by blasting people in any of the great first-person shooters VR has to offer, or you could take a more productive route and allow VR to unleash your creativity. But if you want that meditation or nature walks, you could do it in one of the many beautiful gaming worlds VR has to offer. Number 6 is pain relief. As well as using VR to relieve stress, studies have shown that you can even use it to relieve chronic and acute pain. Movement and exercise are very important for treating chronic pain, but sadly some patients simply can't do it. Using VR, you can now simulate those walks and movement so the patient now feels like they're receiving all the benefits that real-life exercise can actually give them. There's a link in the description below to an article about the work of pain researcher Diane Gramala, who's done a lot of work with VR and pain relief, if you'd like to know some more. And as a bonus part, I did want to keep this video more about the benefits of general VR use rather than the benefits of things that you could do in VR if you wished, but there are certain things I can't really ignore in a video like this. The ability to experience situations from the safety of your own home is obviously good for you for many reasons. There are many dangerous pursuits that can be done in many VR games that you really wouldn't be able to do safely in real life and just aren't the same when you're pancake gaming. You wouldn't be able to walk a wooden plank off the 10th floor of a high rise in real life, but you can in VR and it's totally safe.
He did it.
Most of the time. In the same way, you can use VR to experience your greatest fears or phobias at your own pace, all the while knowing that you can just whip the headset off if it all becomes a bit too much. You could take part in more simple pursuits like going to the cinema in big screen without having to worry whether your seat's been thoroughly cleaned by the staff. And finally, free experiences such as Anne Frank VR and Travelling While Black allow you to step into someone else's shoes and experience life from a different point of view. But why is that good for you? Well, if you really take in an experience like this, you can become more aware of the struggles and problems other people face. You're not being told about these issues, you're actually experiencing them. This could make you a more empathic person, which will lead you treating other people better. If you're still asking why this is good for you, then maybe it won't work for you. But remember to treat others how you yourself would like to be treated. And that's it for this video, but I'm sure there are many, many other ways in which VR is good for you that I haven't even spoken about or even thought about. If you can think of any, please let us know in the comments. And if you've been positively affected by VR in a way, I'd love to hear about that too. If you found this video helpful or enjoyed it in any way, please leave a thumbs up and consider sharing the video with any friends who you still haven't managed to convince just how great VR is. So I've been Al. Thanks for watching the VR Cauldron. Take care of yourselves, and I hope to see you next time. See ya! We'll